Soup is on over here in Studio B, and today we're looking to fill these empty bowls. Got a great way to do it. It's a two-day event called Empty Bowls going on at the River City Food Bank, and it is a way that you can come together with other community members to help feed those who go hungry every day. So joining us today with the soup is Chef Keith Franson, who's with Cafe Bernardo, and Eileen Thomas from the River City Food Bank. Thanks for coming in, both of you.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, so let's talk about the soup. Got the soup starting.
So I got the soup starting. I got onions, I got garlic, and I got butter sitting in there
yes,
right now.
Yes, you do.
since we don't have very much time, I'm just going to throw all the ingredients in.
Okay.
So we have carrots. We got potatoes, and to that, you just want to add your water.
I like that you left the skin on the potato, too.
Oh, definitely. That's where the nutrients are.
Mm-hmm.
So from there, really, we don't have very much time, so what we're going to do is you pretty much boil it. You want to get the potatoes and carrots to be tender, and then once that's tender, you add your cream,
mm-hmm.
your salt, and then you're going to peppers.
Peppers kind of big.
You can even just throw it in whole because you're just going to blend it. Everything's going to be in chunks. Once you blend it, you're going to puree it. And then once you puree it, get your scallions, put it on the soup.
And voila, you've got
That's
all
it.
Of that. Isn't that amazing that comes from that?
Right.
With all that chunky stuff in there? I suppose you could also kind of do it a little bit more fine and just do it as more of a brothy soup, too.
You can do that, too.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Relatively easy to make, and Eileen,
Definitely.
Soup, especially on a day like this where you've got the rain coming in this afternoon, such a cozy thing. Talk a little bit about Empty Bowls and what a success it's been over the years.
Well, this is our 11th year with Empty Bowls, and we have bowls from artists who are professional, artists who are beginning out, artists who are students, and they all put a little bit of their heart into their creation, and we offer these as part of the ticket price. So when you come to our event at the convention center, you get to choose a bowl, and then you get to help yourself to some fabulous soups.
The bowl part of it, I think, is also just fun, and this is one of the ones that was made for you and donated this year.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about this one.
This is from a student at Granite Bay, and we love it because it's so whimsical. And that's the beauty of all the bowls that come to us, is they're all different, they're all unique, they're all just absolutely fabulous.
And you still have tickets available?
We do have tickets available. Our website, rivercityfoodbank.org, and they're $60 for the evening event and $30 for the luncheon event.
What's the big thing that you hope? I mean, obviously you get a great meal and you get a really fun bowl to bring home, but what's the bigger message that you hope people get by taking part in the experience?
Right. The bigger piece is that there are lots of empty bowls in our community. These are symbolic of people who are hungry and don't know where their next meal is coming from. So this event helps us to provide healthy and nutritious food to them.
Great. All right. One more question for in the soup.
Definitely.
Can you freeze it if you put cream in it?
Yes. Go ahead and freeze it, and then when you're ready, just pop it in the microwave. I can actually put a little water in there just to reintroduce it back, and then it'll be fine.
Good deal. All right. Thanks to both of you for coming in today.
Definitely.
River City Food Bank's Empty Bowls event is going on Monday and Tuesday. March 10th, the soup supper will be taking place from 5:30 to 7:30 p.m., and then March 11th, the lunch is going on. Two different sessions of that. One is at 11:30 to 12:30, and then the second one will go from 12:30 to 1:30. And we'll be back with more right after this.